Welcome back. Today, I'll be telling you how you can take control of your writing and turn your creativity on at will. Let's get into it. You know the feeling. You finally screw up the courage to sit down and put the thoughts in your head on paper. There's a story in your chest, itching to burst forth and be born onto the page. You sit at your computer to deliver your newest bundle of literary joy into the world and... crickets. Only moments ago, your mind was swarming with the possibilities of what you would write. But now they vanish as a wisp on the wind. Where did they go? Will they ever return? You still have a story inside you clawing to get out, but now the beast has gone timid. It sulks at the back of its cage and glares at you for not releasing it sooner. What's even worse is the memory of not long ago when you opened the cage and the beast pounced and roamed freely. Creativity flowed like water from the falls of inspiration. Before you knew it, a whole day had passed and several thousand words had tumbled onto your page. Where's that day now? The good news is you can learn to turn your creativity on like a faucet. It doesn't always need to be a slow drip in the back of your mind, only temperamentally gushing of its own accord. It'll take time, but you can learn to control the flow at will. Before I continue, this video is inspired in part by the work of Ayn Rand. I mention this because Rand isn't everyone's cup of tea. She's quite divisive and her opinions aren't for everyone. Actually, I don't know if it's her opinions that are the problem or the arrogant swagger with which she presents them. I'm one of her fans and even I'm blown away by her bombastic egotism. Although I find her writing and philosophy interesting, she does have a habit of saying things that are nothing less than eye-rollingly stupid. But even so, she was an extremely talented writer by any standard. The divisive nature of her work is a testament to that. She was the type of author you either love or hate, with very little in between. She's able to communicate her premises so clearly and vividly, you can't help but either love or hate her work. The only reason I'm able to take a middle ground stance on her work is that I approach it from a literary view instead of a political one, and it's for this reason that I sought to learn from her. This video, and many others in the series to follow, are inspired by her work, The Art of Fiction, which I highly recommend. It's not as complete as other books on writing I've read, but it still has some incredibly useful insights from one of the most remembered authors of our age. Before we continue, don't forget to like, subscribe, and ding the bell so YouTube will notify you when I upload new videos. And don't forget to check the description of this video for book recommendations, as well as all the tools and resources I use in my writing and video production. Back to the video. Know your language. It should go without saying that an author needs to know the English language, but it's a far cry from knowing the English language as a layman and understanding the English language as an author. It's the difference between knowing how to drive and knowing how to drive in New York. Anyone with a driver's license can drive anywhere in North America. I could go from Ottawa, west to Burnaby, south to Sacramento, and east to New York. Maybe I could even muddle my way through the streets of New York if need be. But unless I drive the streets every day and steep in the rhythms of the city, I will never be as proficient as a New York City cab driver. They will know routes and shortcuts based on the city's topography, patterns, and quirky habits that I could never know. And so it is with you and language. The written word is your New York. Anyone can put pen to paper and craft an email or a story, but your work deserves better. You need to steep in the English language. Its rules and shortcuts need to become as familiar with you as the streets are to our New York City cab driver. But don't confuse this with license to become long-winded. The Pareto principle applies here. The principle states that 80% of our results come from 20% of our actions. 80% of the time you spend in your home is on 20% of the floor space. 80% of a business's sales come from 20% of its clients. 80% of complaints come from 20% of customers. It's one of those rules that seems to hold true across many disciplines and boundaries. It's by no means perfect, but it's good enough for us to make plans by. It's also been shown that 80% of the words we speak compose of only 20% of our vocabulary. That might not sound like much, but in the hands of a skilled author, it can be incredibly robust. Consider that, in spite of the vast amounts we spend on education, even most high school graduates only read and write at a 10th grade reading level. Even Ernest Hemingway only wrote on a 6th grade level, and he was Ernest Hemingway. Being a good author doesn't mean being long-winded, but it does mean being proficient with your craft and the tools you have. Expanding your vocabulary will allow you to express your ideas more fully to your audience. Rather than making your writing long-winded, many authors have noticed the opposite. Their writing gets much tighter and more succinct as they grow. It gets easier to read because you need fewer words to get the same message across. Each sentence gets more densely packed with information because we use more precise words in their creation. And it's your job to deliver this precision, even if your audience may not appreciate it. Your audience won't always notice the subtle difference between a dictator and a despot, but you need to. They may not know why they like a certain passage, only that they do. They may not know why a character resonates with them, only that they like him. This is what you should strive for. To be the invisible composer in an orchestra of ideas. The particular tone of each instrument may be lost on the individual, but the whole should add up to a harmony of ideas that strikes at the heart of your audience. To reach this level, your writing needs to become subconscious. You need to be able to pull the exact word you need from the ether of your mind on a moment's notice. That may sound daunting, but it's completely within your grasp. It will seem unnatural at first, but that's part of the process. That's it for this video. In the next video, we're going to talk about the path to mastery and how you can become the hero of your own story. I'll see you then. Until next time, good reading and Calamus Gladio Fortior.